where they're at, Benjamin and Andrew, because John cannot do what I'm doing right now because of a travesty. He cannot touch his own son. When this case was first brought to North Carolina by Frank Jones, a retired police officer and mentor of John, our lawyers in North Carolina quickly realized that a great injustice had been perpetrated against one of the best and brightest sons of North Carolina. We immediately joined forces with Ed DeBose. We called him and told him at the Georgia State Conference, and Georgia and North Carolina, we agreed together to take this to our national board because the nation needed to know about this case. John McNeil has done what is right. He went to school right. He finished high school right. He stayed out of trouble despite the trouble around him right. He played basketball right and became a McDonald's All-American. He went to college right, graduating from Elizabeth City State University, a historically black college and university. He married his wife right. He became a father right. He became a highly successful businessman right, a model citizen right. And nearly 6 years ago, when his teenage son called him on a cell phone and told him of an armed trespasser threatening his life, John did what was right, what any father would do. He called 911, told his son to go in the house, and came home to protect his son. When that armed trespasser came on his property and approached his car, John still did what was right. He told the aggressor to stay away. He only pulled and showed his gun with no clip in it as a deterrent, thinking that surely the man would stay off of his property. He only put the clip in the gun when the armed trespasser kept up the aggression and was approaching him in the car. He got out of the car and begged the trespasser to stay away. John then did more than right. He restrained himself. He backed up. He walked away. He fired a warning shot in the ground and only shot when the armed trespasser kept coming and kept cursing and kept approaching, and there was no other option. A white eyewitness, homeowner, said that John did what was right. Hear me now. Two white senior detectives who investigated the case said John did what was right and ruled it self-defense, and though a tragic death had occurred, for death is always tragic, he went back home with his family. Not 100, not 150, not 200, not 250, but 274 days later, a DA in Cobb County, whose authority oversees the city of Kennesaw, where John lived, a city where it is illegal not to possess a gun. That DA, 274 days after two senior white detectives said John had acted in self-defense, arrested him, had him tried, had him convicted, despite the white eyewitnesses, despite the historic testimony of two white cops in a southern court declaring that a black man accused of killing a white man acting in self-defense. You don't have any case law like this anywhere in jurisprudence in the South. John did what was right. Tragic, but right. And John was convicted because Georgia did what was wrong and unjust.
Right.
And now John, a model man, a good man, a North Carolina man, is in prison for life. That's wrong. John couldn't be with his own mother when she died less than a month ago. That's wrong. John can't be with his wife who is suffering from terminal cancer. That's wrong. John, a proud black man, can't raise his black sons like me. That's wrong. God, John can't contribute to society. That's wrong. And if this can happen, and Ed and I agree hand in hand, if this can happen to John McNeil, it can happen to Ed DeBose.
Yes, it will.
It can happen to William Barber.
Yes, it
can happen to Ben Jealous.
Right. Yes.
It can happen to any black man standing out here or standing anywhere in America.
Yeah. All right.
No matter how much good you've done,
right,
or how right you are. And so we ask the question, is the world to believe that your home is not your castle?
Right.
That you cannot say protect yourself in self-defense? Is the world to believe that you cannot protect your children and your property if you are a black man in Georgia?
Come on.
Or a black man in America?
Mm.
Something wrong here.
Wrong.
Very wrong.
Yes.
Legally wrong. Morally wrong. Chief Justice Sears said it was wrong. And we will tell the world it is wrong. We will fight every way legally because it's wrong.